why I can go in any B-Dawg hood and all type of generation niggas, like, put it like this. I'm 38 years old, so in my 20s I was helping niggas. I was helping niggas my age and niggas that was younger than me. So the older I got, the older they got. And there ain't no telling what kind of status that they got in their hood now. I might pop up in the hood like the Pueblos. I got a homie in the Pueblos, he in the pen right now, but when I pop up over there, and they over there beefing with the vets, gonna kill me not knowing who I was. And look like Rum. Like, what's up, my nigga? Put their guns up and everything, like, Rum, nigga, you don't remember me? I'm like, no, my nigga, what's up? Like, nigga, you taught me whoop-de-whoop when I was seven, nigga. You used to come over the house and whoop-de-whoop. I'm like, damn, my nigga.
What's the worst?
A crip nigga was standing at my car window. Blue khaki suit on, blue chucks, blue strings. Whole bob in his back pocket. Looked at me. Looked at my girl, looked at the kids in the car. Said, he's a cuz, he got a beautiful family. He said, I could kill you right now, cuz, but you be doing your music shit, and I respect that. I ain't even worried about you, my nigga. I just looked. While he was talking, I closed my eyes, my nigga, like, I know he's gonna. And when he said, I'm not even gonna fuck with you, cuz, because you doing your music shit tough, I respect that. I opened my eyes and I looked at him. He said, if you was one of your homeboys, you'd be dead right now in front of your family. And turn around and walk back across the street slow, nigga. Stop traffic and everything. I was like,
Good night.
It's like shit like that. That when you ask the homie earlier, did music save your life? Like, yeah, cause Crips, I be in places where Crips supposed to just have me, and they be like, cuz you hard, and don't fuck with a nigga. So if they respecting me like that on the street, why do I keep limiting myself to only make music for B-Dawg?
Exactly.
And I don't want to do that no more. I've been making gangster music for 15, 20 years and it hasn't paid off. All I got is hard work. You the hardest nigga. But I'm broke, motherfucker. What good is being talented and being hard if it ain't paying off? Like, all my homies sell dope and pimp and all that shit and prosper. They living life prospering by doing raw shit. I'm living life right, not running out on my girl, taking care of my kids, doing my music shit. I live like this, like I'm living, but I don't deserve to be like doing as bad as I'm doing.
Right.
So I'm like,
Pop Simples, man. Rapstatus.com.
I gotta keep it 100. That's
you see it. Live a red rum, 781.
Spit that legendary OG
set into motherfucking one way. The homies banged up, meeting up on a Sunday. Went across the street just to get some brews and shit. What do you know? Somebody slipping wearing blue and shit. It's on, take the flag out my pocket. Wrap it around my knuckles, make a fist and lock it. Deposit, a blow to the jaw as I bank them. Break a folio on top of the counter, then I shank them. It's the power rules, the G's with the rhymes. Four clip shot, enemies 8 times with the 9. I got love from the east side.
Man, 5 bullet holes. I got shot when I was 13. I caught 3 when I was 13. And shit, I caught 2 more after I got grown, you know what I mean? And, I mean, that shit right there come with the territory. You know, I ain't dead, but it will open your motherfucking eyes and shit, you know what I mean?
Like, they stupid.
Next time, they might get me in a temple or something. They might kill me next time, so it made me change my shit up, but you know what I mean? I'm still out here in the street. It's still whatever. You know, I still move around in different neighborhoods, and I mean, if a motherfucker slide up on me, then they just slide up. It's going to be what it is. I'm going to try to explain to a motherfucker first how I get down and what I do. Then, and if they can't accept that, that's when it's, you know what I'm saying? All right,
well, come on, nigga.
That's when they go back into the archive and pull my rag back out.
Because we want youngsters to see this, right? We ain't glorifying gangbang. I'm taking, this is a lifestyle. It ain't no choice. If you live on such and such street,
I know
what
gang,
I know what run that, what code, what conduct.
That's where you from. Where I grew up at, that's what it was. If you lived in the neighborhood, you was basically training because you watching these niggas do what they do. And eventually, that's what you're going to end up doing if you don't get up out of there and move to a different, just a whole different part of town. Yeah. But now, gangbanging is everywhere. You can't even escape it now. You can say it was fun. It was more respectful. You know what I mean? Little homies used to get DP'd, and that was the end of that. You know what I mean? Now, little homie get DP'd, he come back shooting.
Yeah.
It is now. So, gangbanging is basically played out if you ain't an original nigga. I figure if you didn't start gangbanging back in the 80s, If you gangbang anytime, start gangbanging during the 90s and the 1000s, I mean, you ain't really no gang member. You know what I mean? Gangbanging was played out, getting played out by that time. You know what I'm saying? So if you start gangbanging right now in 2010, man, you ain't gonna, I mean, Millennium. Motherfuckers ain't gonna have your back or none of that right now. Motherfuckers is for they self right now. It's all for self. You know what I'm saying? With them gangs and